ओके डियर स्टूडेंट्स, टुडे वी विल डिस्कस चैप्टर नंबर 3 करंट इलेक्ट्रिसिटी। सो करंट इलेक्ट्रिसिटी इज अ ब्रांच ऑफ फिजिक्स विच डील्स विथ चार्जेस आर अंडर मोशन। ओके ना, सो चार्जेस आर अंडर मोशन मीन्स देर आर टू टाइप्स ऑफ मोशन। वन इज विथ कॉन्स्टेंट, चार्जेस आर मूविंग विथ कॉन्स्टेंट वेलॉसिटी। सेकेंड विन विल बी मूविंग विथ वेरिएबल वेलॉसिटी। ओके ना, सी करंट इलेक्ट्रिसिटी मीन्स इट इज अ ब्रांच ऑफ फिजिक्स, इट इज अ ब्रांच ऑफ फिजिक्स विच डील्स विथ वॉट द चार्जेस आर अंडर मोशन, चार्जेस आर अंडर मोशन। ओके, so charges are under motion means there are two types of motions. So one is charges are in motion. Okay na, if the charges are in motion, one is constant velocity with constant velocity, second one will be with variable velocity. With variable velocity. Okay. If charges are moving under constant velocity, it is called your current electricity. Okay, na? It will be your current electricity. Okay. When the same charges are moving under variable velocity, then it is called your electromagnetism. Electromagnetism. Okay, what I told? Current electricity is a branch of physics which deals with the study of charges are under motion. Okay, if charges are under motion, there are two types of motions. One is with constant velocity. Second one will be charges are moving under variable velocity. So if the charges are moving with constant velocity is called your current electricity. Then this charges are moving under variable velocity, then it is called your electromagnetism. Okay. Next, see what is electric current. Okay. So next will be what is electric current. See, electric current. Electric current, it is denoted by I. Okay, it is denoted by I. Then I is equal to Q by T. Okay, na? I is equal to Q divided by T. So I is equal to Q divided by T means, what should I tell here? Oh, shit. This electric current is equal to Q by T. Okay, now how to define electric current? It is the rate of flow of charges is called your electric current. What is electric current? A rate of flow of charge. Okay, now rate of flow of charge is called your electric current. Then what is the SI unit of electric current? So SI unit of, what is the SI unit? So I is equal to Q by T is there. Okay, I is equal to Q by T. Then what is SI unit of Q means charge? It will be coulomb divided by time will be in second. So coulomb per second, or it is called ampere. Or it is called ampere is the SI unit of your current. So when we are going to say 1 ampere, is or not? So when we are going to say 1 ampere, so if I is equal to Q by T is there, when Q is equal to 1 coulomb, then T is equal to 1 second. Okay. Then I is equal to what? 1 divided by 1, it will be ampere. okay, 1 divided by 1 ampere. So now what is the definition of ampere? What is the definition of ampere? The current is said to be a 1 ampere when 1 coulomb of charge is flowing through the conductor in 1 second is called your 1 ampere. Okay, na? It is your 1 ampere. Then, is the current is a scalar or else a vector quantity? Is or not? It must be a scalar quantity. Okay, na? See here. I am taking our electric current. Okay, na? Electric current. So, electric current, it has direction. Okay, na? Similarly, it has magnitude. So, if there is both direction and magnitude, it must be your what? Vector quantity. It must be your vector quantity. But current is your scalar quantity. Why? Because it may not holds good vector additions. Okay, na? Because current is scalar quantity. Okay, na? Just because it will not obey vector addition. Vector addition. Okay, na? Either triangular vector addition or parallelogram of vector addition. Okay, it may not holds good. How? See here. I am drawing a diagram. Vector addition of parallelogram vector addition I am taking here. Okay, na? So, parallelogram vector addition. See. Vector A, it will be your vector B. Here is your resultant. So, what is the resultant here? Okay, na? So, it will be theta I am going to take here. So, vector addition, this resultant is equal to root of a square plus b square plus 2ab cos theta. Okay, na? So, vector addition of two vectors. So, in case of current, what happens? What happens? Let us consider one wire having a 5 ampere of current. One more wire, it has 3 ampere of current making an angle theta. These two are directly added as 8 ampere. Okay, na? It is directly added as 8 ampere itself. 8 ampere itself. We are not going to use this a square plus b square plus 2ab plus cos theta. We are not at all using. Why? Because currents are directly added. These are directly added. See, 8 ampere, it is your 3 ampere. Okay, na? Both are moving with same as 8 plus. Means 3 plus 5, it will be 8. Okay. Similarly, one more example I am taking. So, it is your 5 ampere. Again, it is your 2 ampere. Makes an angle theta here I am taking. Okay. So, after of addition these two, the current will be 7 ampere itself. Don't use the formula. This is a square plus b square plus 2ab plus 2ab cos theta. Don't use that. See, if you want to use, we are not at all getting 8 ampere as a current. Okay, na? So that's why we may call as current is a scalar quantity just because of it may not holds good vector addition of two vectors. Okay, na? So next, see the next. So whether the scalar is vector or scalar. Okay, na? This is means it will be your current. Formally, we can say that it is your scalar quantity. It is your scalar quantity. But actually, if I want to tell whether this current is a scalar or vector, in option, he may give like this. Current is a scalar quantity or else a vector quantity. One more quantity is there. It is your tensor quantity. Okay, na? So particularly if he asked The current is a scalar vector or a tensor. You just put your answer as a tensor quantity. Okay? It is particularly the current is a tensor quantity. Okay? Na? Then see, current density. Next will be current density. This current density is denoted by J. Okay. This J is equal to I divided by A. Okay. So current density is equal to I divided by A. How to define this current density? The current density is defined as it is the ratio of current flowing in the conductor with a area of cross section A is called your current density. Then what is the SI unit of current density? So here SI unit of current density, this J is equal to current will be in ampere divided by area. It will be meter square. It will be meter square. So SI unit we are getting ampere per meter square, or else this J is equal to ampere per meter square. Okay, na? Ampere per meter square is our answer. Okay, then see here one more factor. I is equal to Q by T, I had told. Okay, na? So current is equal to what I had told? This current is equal to I by T. I is equal to Q by T, I had told. If I want I average is equal to, so this average current is equal to Q by T. Okay. Average current is equal to, means it will be delta Q divided by delta T, then I instantaneous current, it is a very important, okay, instantaneous current is equal to, it is dQ divided by dt. What is instantaneous current? It is the current flowing in the conductor at instant time, is called your instantaneous current, okay. Then come to the point of next, electric current in the conductor. Okay, na? See this one, electric current in the conductor. Okay, na? When the electric current will be in the conductor, when the current will not be in the conductor. See here, let us consider it is your conductor, solid conductor. So if it is your solid conductor, then what happens? So electrons are tightly bounded. So if I take any kind of gas, then what happens? The molecules are loosely bounded. So to this conductor, initially I am not at all giving any kind of external force, or else I am not at all applying a battery to this. So what happens? There is a lot of electrons. So before applying a battery to this conductor, then what happens? The electrons under motion. Of course, I agreed for that. The electrons are under motion just because of thermal velocity, but no preferential direction. Okay? So just keep in your mind what I had told. In the conductor, there is a number of electrons. They are under motion before applying a battery. Then just because of thermal velocity. Okay, na? These are under motion in thermal velocity. In which direction they may move? We don't know. Okay, na? So see here, it is your E. It may move along this direction. 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 Then what happens here? So there is no preferential direction. If there is no preferential direction, means electric field must be zero. Okay, na? If the electrons are under motion in the same direction or else in unidirectional, then it is called the electric field will be there and the current is flowing through the conductor, we can say. Okay, so these are moving in any direction means electric field or else net electric field inside the conductor must be zero. Okay, na? When I am applying this battery, then what happens? Positive charge. These negative charges are attracted to this positive charge. Is or not? These are attracted to positive charge. Then what happens? All the electrons are moving in one direction. All the electrons are moving in one direction. So all the electrons are moving in one direction. Electric field is always opposite to the electrons. Okay, na? Means, see here, current as well as electric field, both are in opposite direction. Means, if the current is moving along this direction, electric field will be along this direction. Both are in opposite direction, we can say. Okay, na? When battery is applied, means external force had given to this conductor to move electron in one direction. Okay, na? So, F is equal to, I can write the equation, this F is equal to Q into E. Is or not? So, it is perfectly related to charge. If I want in electrons, F is equal to minus E times of E. Okay, na? See here. So, force I have calculated, but E inside, electric field inside the conductor, it must be zero when no external battery is applied. Okay, na? So, E inside, when no battery is applied. No battery is applied. Okay, na? Then what we can say here? If no battery is applied, then E inside electric field must be zero. Okay, so electric field must be zero means average velocity is also zero. Okay, so this average velocity is also zero. Then average velocity can be written as what? U1 plus U2 plus U3 plus U4 up to UN divided by N. Okay, na? Okay. Then, when the external battery is applied, then what happens? Electric field will be there. Means, electric field may not be zero. Okay? So, when battery is applied, okay, na? When the battery is applied, then what happens? So, this E, electric field inside, may not be zero. If external force is given by using this battery, is or not? Okay, this F is equal to, shall I write, E times of E. Okay, na? E times of E. Then, we know that F is equal to MA. F is equal to MA. When these electrons are under motion, then what happens? That must have the acceleration. Is or not? So that must have the acceleration means in which acceleration that electrons are moving, I want to calculate now. Okay. See here, F is equal to MA, we know it will be minus EE. So A is equal to, what should I write now? A is equal to minus EE divided by M. So this electrons are moving in the conductor with the acceleration of A is equal to minus EE divided by M. Okay, na? Then one more important factor is there. What is the relaxation time? Okay, see here. What I told, this electron, let us consider, I am considering only four electrons here. Okay, electron, 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 electron. Then what happens? This electron is collision with this electron. Then what happens? The motion of the electron is takes place. Motion of the electron is takes place. So, when this electron hits to this electron or else collision with this electron, then what happens? The time is taken or not? the collision between these two electrons is takes place, there must be a time. That time is called your relaxation time. Next will be relaxation time. So it is denoted by tau. So relaxation time means the average, means see here, it is the average time between two successive collision is called your relaxation time. Okay na? So it is about electric current in the conductor. Okay na? So in the next video we will discuss what is drift velocity and related derivations. Thank you.